Hello lovelies, so today we're starting off with this face, and we can't forget about our coffee on this lazy slash rainy day. It's so good. So first, of course, I'm starting off with my moisturizer from Clean and Clear, and I'm just putting that all over my face and blending it in to get my face to look a little more awake. Next, I'm going in with my Covergirl 3-in-1 foundation, and again, I'm also dotting that on my face to blend it in with my Real Techniques Expert Face Brush. I'm going to stipple that on and go in circular motions till I get the desired look that I want. Also, don't forget to blend it out on your neck, that way your face matches your neck and you don't look like two different colors. Got my own money, don't need any man in this room. My boyfriend, he'll be calling me now and it's time. I need all my girls to keep him off my mind. So hold up, we need another one. What we got is all good. Alright, now that that's finished, we're moving on to our concealer, and I'm using my NYX concealer in beige, and I'm just putting that under my eyes to cover up my dark circles. And I'm also going to put that on my eyelid because I use that as a primer. Then I'm going to just put it on the other side as well. Also, we can't forget about covering up our blemishes, so now I'm just covering up any pimples or redness. Next, I'm going in with my Bare Minerals Face Powder Brush and using my Coty Air-spun Powder and just patting that into my skin so the foundation is set. I don't want to rub it around because then the foundation will move. And also, don't forget to pat that onto your neck, because whatever foundation you put on your neck, you also need to set it. And I'm not putting it on my upper lip because I've noticed that if I do that, then the foundation tends to come off. Then I'm going in with a contouring brush, I believe it's from Walmart, and with my Hoola bronzer, I'm just going to contour the hollows of my cheeks. Once I've got the desired amount, I'm also going to contour my temples and the tops of my forehead and also the bridge of my nose and my neck. And again, of course, drinking my coffee. So then I'm using my Real Techniques blush brush, and this color is actually an eyeshadow by Milani, but it is gorgeous. It's a purplish pink, so I'm using that to put on my cheeks. And since this is a lazy makeup tutorial, I'm just going to tame my eyebrows. I'm not going to fill them in because mine are already dark anyways. Okay, then I'm using the color Nude from the Lorac Pro Palette, and I'm just going to put that all over my lid, and I'm not using a brush, so don't judge me, but I feel like the color goes on better. And I'm also going to put that under my brow bone, that way it gives the highlighted effect. Okay, after I finish that, I'm going in with the same color Nude and putting it in my inner tear duct. That way my eyes look a little more awake. Then I'm going in with an Eco Tools blending brush, and I'm using the color Sable from the Lorac Pro Palette. And I'm just going to put that into my outer corner and blend it in. I after I've blended that in, I'm going in with a darker brown. I'm using Espresso from the Lorac Pro Palette again, and I'm just going to do the same thing and put it in my outer corner and blend, blend, blend. All my girls stand in a circle and clap your hands, this is for you. Ups and downs, highs and lows, and no matter what, you see me through. Next, I'm using a small pencil brush, and I'm going in with the lighter brown color that I used before, and I'm going to put that on my lower lash line. That way the top of the eye doesn't look so heavy compared to the bottom. And also, you can use this as a technique so you don't have to use eyeliner. Next, I'm going in with a NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk. And you could use a white eyeliner for this also, but this is just what I had on hand. And you're just going to put that on your lower waterline. That way your eyes look more awake. Next, I'm just curling my lashes to get ready for my mascara. And a technique that I've been using if I am in a lazy mode and I don't want to do two coats, I take the eyelash wand and I curl the top of them as you're seeing now. And I'm just doing that. That way your eyes look more thicker and you don't have to do two coats. After the mascara is done, I'm using my EOS Lip Balm in a Raspberry, and I'm just putting that on my lips to moisturize them. Then I'm going in with my NARS Lip Gloss, and I believe it's Niagra, and I'm just applying that to my lips to just give more color. Then I'm going back in with the nude color that I used on my eyes, and a trick is to put it on your Cupid's bow or just a light color. That way your lips have a more full look. So this is the finished makeup look, and after I drink my coffee once again, we're on to the hair. So this is my hair, and it's looking rough today, so that's why it's going up. So you're just going to pull all of your hair up into a high ponytail, and once you've smoothed it all out, then you're going to hold your hair, don't put it in the ponytail yet, but you're just going to slowly wrap it around, as I am now. Then once you've got it wrapped around, you're going to take the ponytail holder and wrap it around twice. Once you've got that secured, you're going to just pull it out, that way it doesn't look so done, and give it a more messy look. Then of course I've got to take my bobby pins and pin that sucker in so it does not move. Once I finish that, I have to do something with my horrible bangs. So I decided just to throw it in a regular braid. If you don't know how to braid, then you could just simply twist it and pin it up. But I'm just doing a quick braid, and after I've done that, I'm just going to pin it up to the side of my head with a bobby pin. And after you've done this, I like to pull some extra hairs down. That way it gives it more of a less done look and it looks more natural rather than you've taken so much time on it. So this is the finished hair and makeup look for a rainy or lazy day. I hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you next time. Bye!